We're off to Barg Hop's Hospitality District. And why not? What's the worst that can happen? That's what I say. What's the worst that can happen? Other side of the planet. Let's slow it down a little bit. It's like Twitch ads. They're just such a pain. They really are. I'm gonna turn those off. So here is Barg Hospitality District. Hello, Barg Hospitality District. We're gonna get there in our land, we're gonna shoot everybody. Because why not, right? We're on approach. So there you go. So switch lights. Thanks for following, Commander. Vero, also. Thanks for the furrow, Commander. And Don Coyote, thanks for the follow. And about an hour ago, and I'm sure I said thank you to him, Miscellaneous77 also followed. Thank you. So thank you, Commanders, and all those new followers and the people who are in Twitch. You took out a crate, Mark II, with a Viper. That's got to be a engineered Viper. Was the pilot for the crate asleep? Right, Barg Hospitality District. We're on approach. Another thing I've done with this PC as well is I've recently rebuilt it and installed things like Norton and all that guff that I've got. And then I went in there and looked at the scheduling as well of what was going on, and then altered all of that for 10 o'clock in the morning. So frames per second, given what I'm doing, isn't bad because of Streamlabs running and I'm streaming. So it hasn't been so deathly, I don't think. So here's Barg Hospitality District. Somebody's already on the ground. Gypsy and Syntax are already on the ground. Here I come. All power to the shields. We're going down. Woo! Let's get out of the restricted area and land. And then get on the deck. Brilliant. Disembarking. I am on an I'm used to flying the bigger ships, and all of a sudden the small ships, just not used to it. Shoot us out. Let's see what we can do here. There he is, and are we ready? Shields on. Fire. We're in. Have any of these got a decent... Let's cut our way in. There he is. Gone. Little bit of this, little bit of that. Let's scan him up. Cut that open. Chemical samples. Don't really want those. Turn the guns off, because you never can tell. Turn that building atmosphere off. I don't see any data knocking about. Shoot that. Oh yeah, it would have been terrible. They would have just destroyed me left, right, and center. I do like these types of bases. More so than... more so than the bases, the multi, like the holiday places. Not much of a fan on them, to be honest. Always good for a bit of data. Photo albums, payroll, job applications. Bit of swag. But it's the data we are really after. Level 3? Good grief. Still no financial projections. I mean, we are lacking financial projections here. I mean, what is going on? Everybody needs them. We are recharged. Let's go. Gypsy. There you go. Ease down. They're dead, Jim. They're all dead. Digital designs, purchase requests, purchase records. My God, where are these financial projections? They're meant to be in these habitat, sort of like hospitality areas as well. Pretty sure I shot him the first time. What we got? Census data, job apps, photo albums. I mean, we'll download the lot. Why not? Like, you know. But hey. Yeah, all the billboard advertising is great. But you're right. It is the tourist bases that do that. Okay, here's another cabin. Anybody in yet? Have that. Right in the mush. Nothing that I want there. And we are away. Travel permits. Again, we're striking out on the old financial projections. good stuff. So, okay, that's our missions done. Back to Clough then, I suppose. So here's a question for people. How many people play Elite in 4K? Here. I'm going to put a poll up on the channel. Because I'm interested. My channel. Community. We're going to do a poll on the channel. Um, 1080p. Is it 22650, isn't it? What is it for video? And then copy. I am just generally interested what people are running. And why? It's 1980. Let's have a look. And then 3840 times 2160 Adds another option. Other. Adds another option. Post. Done. There you go. I'm interested in that. I want to know. I really do want to know. Mike, yes. Good one, Mike. Right, okay. Moving on. Back to Clough then. We got a mission handing going on there. I mean, you get better frame rates, a better experience, I suppose, in 2K as opposed to 4K. Lots of stuff going on. Go on to the YouTube channel. Go to the community tab. It'll be in there. We are gonna skip away from this planet now. All good stuff. There we go. So for the people who have found us back on YouTube and Twitch, 07 Commanders, I hope the sound is also working for you now on Twitch, which is absolutely fantastic. I've just put a poll up on the YouTube channel about what resolutions Commanders play Elite Dangerous in. 1080p, I think it's then 1440, and then whatever 4K is. Oh, your son's poorly, was it? Calpol job, is it? Paracetamol and stuff. We're going to jump. CD 51 2650. Tissues mainly, I see. We're jumping, which is great. And to Clough. Clough base. It's where we're at. It's where we're going. Okay, so we're going to go and hand some missions in. Pick up some new ones. As soon as you get the base, I'll take a quick 2-minute break and go and get another whatever that was. Which wasn't bad. It was wet. And when you consider we've had 2 streams today. Problems with Twitch. Good one, Twitch. So, while all that's happening, let's just get ready because it's going to get us to slow down any time now. Like that, we'll see how things are going on my poll on my YouTube channel. So, let's have a quick look. 5, refresh. 4 votes so far. 1080p. With somebody now then in 2K. Only me in 4K at the moment. Power towards Clough base. It's always you, innit, Simon? It's always you with the bonkers refresh rate. With the bonkers flipping... 1920 by 1200. Is that because you're windowing it? Yeah. Yeah. Oh, 1610 screen. Oh, fair enough. Long and narrow. Sixteen by nine is a cheapo shortcut. Ah, taller. Ah, yes. Okay. /200. That's what you play the game on. In. What? I was going to say, you mad. You're mad, Muriel. You're mad. Yeah, 1080p. A lot of 1080p's coming in. Lots of 1080p's coming in. We're going in. Well, it's Amazon Prime Day soon, isn't it? Or is it, well, when's that coming up now? November, isn't it? Is it November or October? Is it Black Friday? I can't remember. When's Thanksgiving? November. It's like practice Christmas. All my American friends ate that. Oh, so you're off for practice Christmas. And they go, oh! I said, well, there you go. It's indeed practice Christmas as far as I'm concerned. Okay, here we go. Let's request some docking. Right, probably best not to crash into this one. You all thought I was gonna crash into pad 8 then, but I'm not. And we're down. Another happy landing. Yeah, fantastic. 1440p with 240 hertz. Do you know what? It might be the way forward. Let's disembark. Clough base. It's like in the base with streaming. Now this base is a particular big pain in the ass for me, for some reason. And streaming with Mike, Gypsy and Simon connected. So there's got to be some sort of reciprocal going back and forth. I don't know, right? Well, you can see the frames per second on the screen. So here we've got all sorts going on. And I was getting single digits last week. So it's interesting, isn't it? It's like rubber banding, so it's doing something. Hey, there's Mike. Lay it on me, baby. Gypsy's handing his messages in. Let's go and hand that in. See, go to what? 22, 21 frames per second. Slows right down. Projections. Yes. Weapon inventory. That'll do for me. So Mike use that. Over here, mind, where there's not so much going on. Better frame rate. Strange, isn't it? Okay. Projections then. Michael. Because there's nothing there. Shared a new mission. Mike, are you going to lay these projections on me? Because I can't. You know, can we do anything? Go to your backpack. And then down to what? whatever it is you've got. It might have to be on a planet. She might not have him in your backpack. Yeah, so you can do the inventory in the stations, like what Simon says. Have to do it on a planet. Let's get a different mission, shall we? Let's go for something like, I don't know, combat. See, I knew I was going to get beef. Look at all this. They're all naughty missions. Let's look. All naughty missions. Take out Arana's creative commodities personnel. Fine. What do we get for all of this? Tactical plans. Suit schematic. Power regulators. It's all a bit boring, isn't it? Let's have a look. What's that? Same stuff. Operations. These are all boring missions too. Let's have a look. What should we do? Nothing I really want to do there, to be honest. It's all quite simple stuff. I mean, how many have I got to take out? It doesn't say. Threat level 4. Ah, it's all right, isn't it? Why not? We'll do that. They had really good material play. I think we might do that again tomorrow. Right, so I've got 2. And we'll go to Dia and take them as well. Because I don't care. Whew. Right, I got 3. Transactions. Get the synthetic pathogen. I'll take out the conservatives of Tiala. Cool. Let's get to the ship. Go to my hangar. Yeah, I think that might be the answer. We get ourselves over to the system we were at last week and do some more AX restoration missions. I just can't remember the system we were at last week. Yeah, it's an odd problem that is, fish sticks. What I'll do, I'll fly to the outskirts of the base, right? I won't make orbit. And we can meet up and drop them off there. So just tag me, Mike, and then we can crack on. It's an ad. Huh. 25 suit schematics. I got loads of suit schematics. Loads. So have a look what we got. Except brilliant. I've shared some. We got quite a few. I think we're all okay. Brilliant. Let's find a place to land. This'll do. Right. I'm going to go and grab a quick drink. One moment. Okay, I'm back. Okay. Right in. Here he comes, look. Woo, cheeky man. Yes, landing just like me. It's quite the throw on that grenade, wasn't it? Right, no one laugh at Mike landing. We're being hosted, Jack Trice just liked. Obviously, I think my notifications are broken. I think that's just Jack on Facebook liking. But we have 43 people on Twitch. 07 commanders. I hope you're doing okay today. We've got up to 54 viewers at the moment. Here comes Mike. There he is. 07. Great minds. Right then. Financial projections. Citizen Smith. 07. Ooh, well, he's throwing them at me. Wait, here we are, look. 10. Take those data. Yes, thank you very much. I've got them. 07, Commander. Thank you very much. Right then, so, woohoo, we're off. Let's go to the next mission. Here we go. Into the ASP. So, 07, Citizen Smith, hope you're doing... Now we shoot him. I wouldn't do that, it's Mike. Just give me financial projections. Right, we're off ski. So that was Clef Base. Good for that. We're off. Right, where are we going to go first? Who's doing what? We got a couple of cheeky missions. Which one are we doing first? We've shared quite a few. Take out Aranos creative personnel. Let's do that one. Where's that? That's going to be... That one. Brilliant. So it's going to be there then. Over to factions. Aranos creative commodities. Could be them, couldn't it? What we got? Pace chemical holdings. We got a tourism one. Cool. Got a high tech one. Or industrial. Let's try that. The medical bay. High tech. I mean, financial projections are also in engineering enterprise. Here. Let's try that one. Right. Brilliant. Did it do it? I don't think it did it? Yes, it did. There you go. That one. Jump. We're jumping. Let's jump, jump, jump. Here we go. There's our escape vector, Victor. We're off. Right, flipper down. Let's find out where it is. Dawn Treader. 07, Commander. Hope you're doing fine. So we're trying to break away from this planet. As nice as it is, that's what we're doing. As fantastic as it is, that's what we're doing. No dramas. That should be it. Rock over here. Flippers down. Light seconds away. And we're off. So while we're waiting, let's pop up another B media file. Of the stuff that I got sent. So we got to like three. I've got this one, four. Look at this one with the scythe. So here we go. Again, it's all about, it seems to be all about the Quimpets picking up all these escape pods and all that crap. Great, great. I'm getting a good look at them as well. Also like HD stuff. Which is quite good. You know, it's just sat there calmly, rotating. Not bad, was it? I've got one here now more about pulse. There's that red pulse that goes off there as well. Whether that's stunning the pods or stunning ships in the area. That's probably just their test ship. I wouldn't be a bit surprised. You know? And then I got another one. This one here. Pretty much more the same. There's that red pulse going on there again. And I got a video on this coming out on Monday in my normal sort of like 2:30 BST slot talking about the thin pits and what have you. Thargoids with the limpets, I know. Shocking, isn't it? But then, if we look at, let's have a look. I'll have to put a different type of file up. The next stuff. That is a new Thargoid called the Scythe. Now, a glaive is a weapon. As from Krull. Remember that spiky thing? The glaive? Threw it, came back. Didn't chop his hand off. The Scythe is a tool. A tool for reaping a harvest. And with that in mind, you know, it was the harvest is humanity. Let's think on that. That Python was probably their test ship. They could use a camera with, fly around, invisible to everybody. It's a Python. I wouldn't be a bit surprised. That's B footage. I wouldn't say it's gameplay footage. I'll play it again now. Let's just... I'll play it again, Sam. Fine. Open. There's that one, right? And they showed another one, didn't they? There was a python above. So and that's the python. See, python is python. And then the one before that, this, you see the pulse going off and all the rest of that. So that's probably their test ship, their test Python they've got going on. But they're only really short clips they handed out. There's nothing in depth. And the information they gave wasn't really a hell of a lot. Wasn't in depth either. Could be. Right. I hear Jerker. That's what we're going to call it. Engineering base. Going to go in there. We're going to shoot everybody. And be really unpopular. I will play it again, Sam. Big and large. Okay, there's your thin pits going in. There he is. Look, there's your python. Once more. There's your pulse. There's your finpits. Finpiting. Python, Corvette in the background. It's saying detection of a weapon. Well, I haven't got there yet, have I? It's not my weapons are out. Do you see that? Fine. Detection of a weapon. Right. I'm disembarking. I'm going to walk across there. I'm going to shoot everyone. And so I don't lose the ship, I'm dismissing it. Stop shooting my ship. Eliminate the occupant. 21. We're going to walk in all casual like. Well, like the Thargoids need to be any harder, fish sticks. I mean, I know you do it all in a sidewinder, but like, you know, I mean, some of us can do that. Okay, so we have breached the perimeter. So it's one of these high-tech bases, like... There he is. See him over there, look? See that? Completely muffed him. Boom! We don't care. We're going to go in, we're going to take them all out. Here they come. Only 21 people to shoot. We are shooting the peoples. Right, who we got around here then? Grenades everywhere. He's the one I want. Oh, Christ. Quite a few people we've shot there. Level 3, we're scanning. Right, got the keys to the kingdom now. Quick med kit. Who's shooting me now? Seems to be going alright. Up and over. Into the hab. Let's see what's on that slab. Let's irritate him. Turn that off. What we got in here? What we got in here? And a little bit of data. Propaganda. Okay, what we got? Insight, Infinity, Infinity G-Meds, Hush. About that. Up the stairs. Bit of a recharge on the go. Nothing else really worthwhile having up here. A little bit of med kit. We'll have a med kit. Two. See people, ships landing outside. Real. Back out into the night. There's Mike. Here we go, and we're in. Nothing going on down here.
I don't see anything here. Gonna keep...
What's them gone? Have we got any data in here? No, we haven't. A couple of lockers, though. We can loot the place up.
Someone in here?
Yeah, me. I'll have that chip as well. Blow that up, because why not? Turn that off just to be irritating to people. Nothing in there. Inorganic contaminant. That's the answer. These lockers here usually got some good stuff in them. Inorganic contaminant. Pyrolytic catalyst. We'll have it. Don't know what it is. There's our data. Biological weapon data, chemical weapon data, and chemical patents. Well, it's an absolute delight, this place, isn't it? Basilisk paint jobs to the store. I have to have a look at those. God, it's just a minute. Bloody hell, I can't wait a minute. It slows the game right down. What have they done with these data transfer problems? It's crazy, man. Crazy bonkers. I got people to shoot. Oh, yeah, US robotics. You're not wrong there, Sphere Lance. Too right. Didn't even blow the TVs off the wall. Done. Right. Stairs there. Stairs. We'll have them. A load bay. They've taken a few things out. Nothing in you then. Okay. In the command area. Still six people knocking about. There'll be two or three in there. Most of them are going to be in here. We're going to whiz in. Bit of power. It is. That. It's guff. It's guff, Narco. It's guff. It's guff. That'll irritate people. In we go. Into security area. Turn off the alarm. Shoot him. That's the way out. Shoot him. Anybody in here? Doesn't look like. Usually there's a data panel there. There isn't. Usually good stuff in here, mind. There you go. Suit. That it. Yes, and that's what you get for shooting at my ship. You sausage. Straight across. Anybody in here? No data port either. Take the scans off. Little bit of data. Campaign plans. Xeno defense protocols. Yes, we'll have it. I remember having an ISDN link put in, which I think was 2x64K, two lines, with work. And I thought I was the kiddie. This is before broadband. And broadband was all talking about, oh, you know, 5 meg megabits per second. Ooh. And there I was on my 128K ISDN line. You know, cosmic. Utterly crazy when you think about it. ISDN. Oh, it's jinky little swine, isn't she? Me. Ha ha. Downloading data. We'll have that aerogel. Two more to go. One more to go. You know, I remember being on sort of dial-up modem or, you know, the internet, Sky. Oh, we'll give you 5 meg. Ooh, I'll have some 5 meg. And then when we moved to this house, we had, oh yeah, better broadband. 25. It was like, ooh, 25. And it was the point at that point, you were getting a better reaction time due to the contention on a dial-up modem. It was crazy. And then now, I mean, what have I got here? 500? It's 500, it's more like 490 with all the messing about. And 100 up and like 490 down. And it's like, you know, it's just the norm. It's just like the norm. Crazy stuff. Crazy what you get used to. And then, you know, I know people in work who have got like a gig up, gig down. And that's crazy. And then what's next? 2? As things get more and more demanding. I mean, we've got a busy house. I mean, there's 5 of us here. 6 when my other son comes to stay. I mean, the dog's not internet connected, like, you know, don't get me wrong, but it all kind of paints a picture, doesn't it? Of what people's demands are on the internet. And broadband speed. And some view it just as important as electricity. Can you imagine? Well, I'll tell you what it's like when the internet goes down in this house. It's absolute maintenance. It's maintenance. It's absolute flipping carnage. Absolute carnage is what it is. My God, Simon, that's ridiculous. $10 per meg over that limit. I went to a technology conference once, and they were talking about the interconnected pet, and how they'd put like tracking collars on cats and dogs and stuff. More so cats, because they're like kind of free roaming. Dogs not so much, especially my dog, because he'd bugger off. We wouldn't see him again. They were saying how it was going to be the future, you know, internet. And this one particular guy had gone to the Apple Center, and he'd gone to the Apple Center, and he had taken the cat's internet connected collar with him. So there was the cat at Heathrow, and there was the, you know, all this sort of stuff, just to wind the kids up. You know, and it was funny, but I'm not sure we're there yet. You know, I don't know. Interconnected cat. That's a bit crazy stuff. That's supposed, you know, a time when, you know, there was more affluence around. We weren't in like what they say a global economy and all that. And you know, the issue is the issue. Is the issue of the issue. And there it is. Come on, I want that thing. I just pull the handle. Here it comes. Yeah, well, I didn't play the original Diablo. I came into Diablo at Diablo 2. And I remember during the first fuel strike here, back in early 2000s, there was fuel strikes over here with the lorry drivers, and we all had to stay from home and dial in. I remember going, ah, bollocks, I'm playing Diablo. Yo, that's it, the tracking. Where's that cat gone? Where's that cat? It's more a case of like, so where's the cat go when he goes out here, you know, into the murky darkness and all of that? It's people just indulging their curiosity. No one gives a crap where the cat's gone. The cat didn't care. You know? But it's fun. Where's my ship? Oh, I sent it away, didn't I? Bollocks. Oh, dear. Have some of that. We'll steal all of that. And let's go. We're off. Well, exactly. Obviously, that cat had a haunting ground, didn't it? Had a stalking ground. It's like with the dog, right? Wherever he goes with me or the missus. Mostly to the vet, down the road and round the corner, and that's it. Well, I haven't got a cat, but I get it, yeah, you know, but like, they should be. Yeah, they won't be kept long, will they? Yeah, we got a microchip on the dog, yeah. I mean, to be fair, right? When you think about all the inoculations we had, I think we all should have been chipped. I would have been all right to show my arm with all my inoculations on it. I would have been all right with that. But I saved all that messing about travelling just after the pandemic. We had 18 pieces of paper and this and that and God knows whatever else. It was a right pain in the all that was. Actually, yeah, in Cyprus. Bloody cats everywhere. Ah, it's the ship. And over there, there's a bit of rock on fire. We'll go over there and have a look. Gonna have a look at that. Break it up a little bit. Like, why that couldn't have come over here? I just... We're gonna jump. Woo! Got a couple of, you know, fiery places to go and have a good nose at. Perhaps we'll put the Artemis suit on. How can you keep a cat on your property? I mean, the cat is roaming. It's like you open the back door, out goes the cat. Like you were just discussing, where's the cat go? Yeah? You know, it's like, what the bloody hell's all that about? Cat netting on reset. Well, what? Yep. What's next? Tie the cat to a flipping rock or something. Look, the fire. And there's noddies on that as well, look. See, we get a bit of materials here, look. Don't know what it is, though. We'll have to land. Over here. Let's get the car out. Oh, I'd imagine so with the coyotes, yeah. I mean, we haven't got, you know, I mean... Everyone's going on about, oh, there's big cats around in Merthyr. Well, no idea. Bit of carbon. Let's go and find some of these other deposits. Deposit there, deposit here, deposit everywhere. There's a deposit. Piceous cobble. Here it is. Fire! Fire's the weapons. Okay, so zip him around. Brilliant. Bit of sulfur. Crystalline clusters over there. It's worthwhile picking up because you've a few materials here and there. It's not going to hurt, is it? Hook him up to the washing. You're going to come back and find the cat hanging. Tungsten. Ooh, I'll have some of that, sir. Look at that. Come to me. Come to me, come to me, come to me. It's tungsten, right? Apparently. See that there? That's tungsten, that is. Look at this, material collecting as well on this stream. Wow, bloody hell, I've done it all. Pilthorin, yes. What we were talking about was sticking a tracker, an internet tracker, on your cat to see where he goes. That's what we were talking about. But I get it, yeah. There's a balance. It's called the circle of life. And, it's everywhere. Mangalese! Mangalese, Mangalese, Mangalese. Is that Mangalese? Is that going to fall on our head? There you go. Material acquired, baby. Right, where are we going next? I thought there was more than that here, but apparently not. Some over there. Pop over there and go and get them. Well, while we're at it, we'll dismiss the ship and bring it a bit closer. Might not be so mountainous and difficult terrain.
Motion detected at the front.
Thank you. It's a gold paint job. Had it for years on this ship, and this ship has been my go-to ship for absolute ages. Yages and yages. Right. Well, I'm stuck on the thing now, aren't I? Right. Let's get off yet. Let's shoot the thing. There it is. Sulfur. And, you know, all materials are good. Especially when... Right, I just thought someone's at the front door then. Nothing on that one. Right, we've brought the ship back, wherever the ship is. Where's the ship gone? Where's the ship gone? Where's the ship gone? Where's the ship? Where's the ship? Where's the ship? There it is. 500 meters, all the way over there. What, they introduced the rabbits, thought, shit, we've got too many rabbits. I know, we'll bring in foxes. Shit, foxes are killing all the cats. It's like, do they think about this stuff? Iron, any old iron. Here we go, any old iron. Back into the ship. Okay. Board the ship. You're right there, Spear Lance, it has. Yeah, thing is, it's like with animals, isn't it? You know, everything's great. And then people lose interest or what have you, or financial pressures, and then the animal's left to deal with itself. That is the problem. Right, what we got next? Complete. Eliminate Silver Rat's members. Except... Oh, Staroshenko. We're going back in. Yeah, so far we are doing okay on missions. And is that one there as well? 9 out of 10 confirmed. Got to do another one. There it is. Did you see what my dog's doing? Seems alright. Certainly walking a bit better. False alarm. I was stood at a football pitch this morning after seeing the dog limping and going, oh shit, what's the dog done now? That's going to be expensive. More vet bills. And our vet insurance is just mad. No one told me, right? I pay my £30 a month. Ah, yes, but you're only covered for £1,000 per ailment. So when you've got something like diabetes going on, right, that's heavy stuff, isn't it? So, you know, I thought, oh, he's fallen off the settee, he's broken his leg, bloody hell, bloody hell, bloody hell, bloody hell, like, you know. And, well, seems to be walking all right now, thank God. I was like, what? Broken leg on a dog is about £2,000, of which you probably get £1,000 back off the insurance. And you're like, you know, it's kind of got to be done because they're a member of the family too, like, you know. Doroshenko manufacturing facility. Okay, Doroshenko manufacturing facility, we're en route. Yeah, I don't blame you. I don't blame you. So, where are we now? So we're en route. Great. So I get to show you now, and you lovely people who are watching the stream, I'm also going to get to show you. I can do an image slideshow. Add source. Okay. Image files. Add files. I will show you the images of the scythe that I got sent by Frontier. There you go, look. One. See, now, it's having a go there, that scythe, right, at the Corollis. There's another picture, like there, of the scythe and its thimpit. A bit of a bright picture of the scythe there. Looks more like an insect than the normal sort of aquatic sort of starfish thing that we've seen. Looks more aggressive, doesn't it, than what we've seen beforehand. More akin to, like, the basilisk than, say, the cyclops. And that's the one I think Burr Pitt used for his picture. It's a mean looking bug, it really is. That's the one I quite like. You know, so that picture there, can you imagine going in for a rescue mission at a station and those things are swarming around? You think, well, when you're going in there, you know, pick up some people, get some materials, it'll be fine, no worries. Yeah. Yeah, and they're all there, picking up the materials and picking up, you know? It is, it's all heavy stuff. It is, I think they're very aggressive, lots of design work there. So what I'll do is I'll see if I can, oh, I can do that. And I'll have them playing kind of just down there so people can have a look at them like that. How's that? See, image slideshows. Total quality here, Ricardo's gaming, everybody. Woo, there it is. Right, here we go. Whose mission is this anyway? so I know not to land. Gypsy!
I will hover about. Oh, excuse me.
And try not to crash. Power to the shields and the engines. It's okay, we'll wait for Gypsy to land. There he is. Get the gear down. He's landed. See, I'm hidden behind that wall. See? Well, I'm ready, dude. There's an element of truth in there, though, yeah. See, there's my dog woofing. Having a good woof. Are we ready then, fellas? Shoot us out. Looks like we are. There's Gypsy over there. Shields on. Let's. See him gone. Oh, he's dodging my shots. All right, let's get in there. Under attack, under attack, under attack. Scan him up. Chadwick Mills. Oh yeah, it's going to be exciting stuff, the Thargoids. Look at all this mob. Look. Boom. Boom. Have it. What we got here? Fight! We've got one! Finally! We've been two streams. 1 hour and a half here. 3 hours on the other one. Financial projections. Finally. Well, there you go, see? Transfer complete. Dun, dun, dun. Dun, dun. Right. Cool. We should have access to, see, level one, and it's a level two thing there. Will we go over the command center? Level one to get into the command center. Hopefully there's some decent people in here. Level three to get in here, so there'll be some level three stuff going on in there. That's me! Scan them up. Now we can travel anywhere we want. Okay, over here to there. What we got here? Blacklist data, combat training, incident logs, faction donator list, all good stuff. I'll have to put one up. Yeah, I'll have to put a buy order on there in case any of you got any spare. I've got like 12. I don't know how many I need. Forgotten now. Suit energy. That's 12 then. Let's get in here. Cap some people. Get a reload on. Here we go. Upstairs. Work our way down. Another one down. Ease down. Ease down. It's a nice looking command center though, isn't it? You know, stuff. Ionized gas. Two more to go.
There's nothing here. We check elsewhere.
Right in the sausage. One more to go, and I dare say that one more person is by the power unit. Loads of material, nothing down there. Just need to get out now. Through the lab, data pad there. Have I got that one? Purchase request, patient history, download, have a little bit of that. Oh yeah, Dick Van Dyke without self-centering. You just don't know. He's still going, isn't he, Dick Van Dyke? There's the foyer. Bit of power. Let's get out. It's got to be in the power center, isn't it? Oh, we're going in, all right. Have that. Suit schematic there, if anyone wants it. And that's it, we're done. Look at that. Yeah, well, he was in Mary Poppins right at the end, the new one with Emily Blunt in it. Spry old fella. be fair. 90-odd? Alexa, how old is Dick Van Dyke? 97. Joe, probably look as good as that at 97. And there you go. I have, I think, one mission left. And I've got to take out one more person. Well, I've got two missions left. Just in Deer. Ice Storm something or other. Oh, yeah. Yeah, it hasn't got any better, has it? Okay, let's go and break atmosphere. We're off scale. So for those of you who have just joined, 07 Commanders, at the bottom of the screen you'll see a slideshow of press photographs shown by Frontier in regards to the new Thargoid that's coming out, the Scythe. Caught me, innit? Quite enjoyed that Mary Poppins film. It was good fun. I quite liked it. Do you think you go in there and think, oh no, gotta be Julie Andrews. Emily Blunt did a bloody good job. Bloody good job. I've also got a mission there, which is in. Not that one. Another one. But we'll see. Oh, the new one's quite good fun. I said to the kids, come on, we're going to see Mary Poppins. Not something you hear me say every day. But, no, I enjoyed it. It was good. It was really... Was it as good as the original? No. Was it good? Yes. Because the original, also, it's got that nostalgia value, isn't it, right? But a Mary Poppins. Right, we're in the system. That's great. Let's go over here. Deer, and then we say, right, what we got? Ice Storm Squadron. Let's give them a kick in. Ice Storm Squadron. What have they got? Extraction, extraction, more high tech, extraction, extraction, extract. Oh, they got the lot, lock stock, the lot. We'll just go to that military installation. I don't think I can go to that, can I? That's not what I need. I need that. Do the industrial. Can I dock at those? Threat level one. Well, that's not very good, is it? And then Biochemicals. We'll do that. Threat level 2. Might be quite tasty. Five clicks out. Yeah, they made a sequel. It was all right. Oh yeah, anyways, Mary Poppins, right? Then a classic with Angela Lansbury, Bed Knobs and Broomsticks. Who remembers that? Classic Bed Knobs and Broomsticks. It must have been the second time round because it's an old film. I think it's a 60s film. And I was born in the 70s. And I remember seeing it in the cinema. So it must have been like a redo 10 years later. What was his other leg called? Bum bum. Hey! Quality film. No Dick Van Dyke in that, though. There's that other guy with the moustache. The guy with the moustache who played the father in Mary Poppins. The original. He was in it when he played the wizard wannabe. And she was actually a student. I don't know. She was a student of his. And she was actually better. He was on to something. Anyway, whatever. It was a good film. Really good film. Again, watch that. You watch it with the... Remember seeing it yourself, then you watch it with the kids, don't you? And you go, Bed Knobs and Broomsticks. Classic. One of those films that comes on at Christmas time, and you pop it on, and you go, bit of nostalgia. It's like a nice warm hug. You know, a bit of hot chocolate. Bed Knobs and Broomstick. Exactly. There you are, fish sticks. Bed Knobs and Broomsticks, dude. Mary Poppins. Got to watch new Mary Poppins. Bed Knobs and Broomsticks. Tell you what we finished this week, which was really good. And it's on the Disney streaming service, or FX it's on. The Bear. And we'd watched the first season last year when it was on. And Pavil Piper. 07 Commander, thanks for the sub. And the bear, come on. So the idea of this, the guy's obviously got issues. He's a Michelin star chef. He inherits a sandwich shop in Chicago off his brother, who commits suicide. And he wants to turn it into a fine dining Michelin star restaurant. Well, season 2 is amazing. And I've got friends who are Italian. And they bring up, they do a Christmas episode. But it's not... In typical Christmas, everything's all kumbaya and it's all fancy. No, it's absolute family carnage at a dinner table. If you've got Disney Plus, the Disney streaming service, or access to FX, watch The Bear. And this particular episode is called Seven Fishes, which was amazing. Jamie Lee Curtis plays the mother, who's a lunatic, right? Utter lunatic. But it's really good. It's got like 100% on Rotten Tomatoes, which I thought was really bad. But apparently it's not. If you have 0% on Rotten Tomatoes, that's really bad. 100% on Rotten Tomatoes is fantastic, apparently. I think. That is the one with the guy from the US, Shameless, the guy who plays Lip. And he's got like a double barrel name, right? But yeah, utterly brilliant. You all thought I was going to crash, didn't you then? But I didn't. Right. But then I also haven't docked. Now I have. My missus watched a lot of the US Shameless. I came in and watched a couple of episodes. Ones I saw I thought were really good. I thought William H. Macy was William Macy. I see, he was in it, wasn't he? He was good. But I didn't see how it ended. Right. So, you know, that sort of thing. But the beer, it's brilliant. You'll be walking through your kitchen saying to your missus, "Yes, chef." But when you walk behind her, you'll be saying, "Behind." Shields on. Let's go loud. Come on. I seldom use a grenade, but I used one then. That's what I want. Scan them up. Duplicated. Sentry skimmers. Better. He gone. Or he has gone. See? Come on, Frontier. Sort your life out. Come on, I'm trying to get the cupboard open. Blew himself up. They are all coming to me. All I wanted to do was cut that open. You know what I mean? Yes. Nothing that I really want anyway. I'm going to have notoriety most of next week. I don't care though, because it's good entertainment. I haven't seen much epoxy resin lately on my travels. And sometimes you've got to be naughty to get on in the game, right? Weapon test data, troop deployments, and employee genetic data. Give it all to me. Lord Narco. Yes, chef. That's right, chef. Yes, chef. Please and thank you. Can I have hands? Can I walk that steak? Two steaks to walk. It's all that sort of stuff on there. All good stuff. But no. The bear. So yeah, I am taking on the military. Vital signs stabilized. Blowing stuff up. Like only we can. You haven't won yet, but I'm gonna. How many people am I shooting? It's like, this is what it's all about. Not a drum is safe. Might as well rip off all his stuff here while we're at it. Got no time for him. Look at this, it's an absolute rampage. I'm on a goddamn John Wick rampage, everybody. Look at this. Piss them off and depressurize. A couple of things here. How many people are on this base? Epinephrine. Who's there? Dane Roche. Ha! Have that. Taking him out. The one man army. How are we doing for bullets? 27 shots. We'll have to get some. Oh, and just so happens, here's some ammo. Lots of assets to rip off.
Motion detected at the front door.
This is what every mission should be like. Not just the occasional one. Right? And I know I'm gaining notoriety here, but I don't care. I'm getting everything I want. Quite literally. In one sitting. You know what I mean? This is fantastic. Right. I think we've done everybody there. Cool. Ah. There's an army here. Oh, I died. Never mind. That was quite good fun, wasn't it? That was quite good fun. Shame I died. I did have my eye on the ball. Not to worry. But hey, do you know what, everybody? I've had fun this afternoon. I hope you've had fun as well. A little bit of a hiccup in regards to what was going on with the sound in regards to Twitch. No problems there. We restarted the stream and there we go. Had a little look at the videos we've had as well. Shot me in the backside is what he did. So yeah, cool stuff. All good stuff. And we get to do it all again tomorrow. And I think, oh look, I'm at the Champion of Piety. Oh, we'll be redeploying, don't you worry. Perhaps I'll do some more Revenant missions tomorrow, because they were quite good fun once we'd actually found where said Revenant missions were. And what I'll do is I'll get myself in my ship over to whatever it was. I'll look at the last stuff. The sound's gone on Twitch again. You're joking. Anyway, what we're going to do is we're going to knock it on the head there. 07, Commanders.